I have just begun reading Volume 2 of I Am Providence, The Life and Times of H.P. Lovecraft by S.T. Joshi. And I highly recommend this two-volume edition. The single volume that was published by Necronomicon Press, H.P. Lovecraft to Life, is very good. It was published in 1996, October of 1996, and since then we have had so many books published of Lovecraft's writings. We have had the excellent two editions of the annotated Lovecraft from Dell Books. We have had Peter Cannon's magnificent Lovecraft Remembered from Arkham House. And this is a collection of memoirs, people writing about H.P. Lovecraft who knew him or corresponded with him. This is a record of people that encountered Lovecraft, and that has a lot of information. We have had S.T. Joshi's magnificent The Ancient Track, the complete poetical works of H.P. Lovecraft. It's a huge volume. So, Hippocampus Press, of course, published the annotated Supernatural Horror in Literature, complete with index. Hippocampus published the first edition of the newly discovered manuscript of The Shadow Out of Time, which was a manuscript that was thought to be lost. So that, and those, that version of The Shadow Out of Time finally saw print in one of the three Penguin Classic editions of H.P. Lovecraft. I believe it was in this one, Dreams in the Witch House, and I believe. And so we've had these three annotated editions of H.P. Lovecraft's work published by Penguin Classics. Quite historic. We've had more and more letters by H.P. Lovecraft published by Hippocampus Press, including the phenomenal collection of letters between H.P. Lovecraft and Robert E. Howard, and between H.P. Lovecraft and August Derleth. We've had S.T. Joshi's magnificent bibliography. Look at that, that's so huge. All of this stuff has been published since that original biography of Lovecraft was published in 1996. We have the five volumes of collected essays published by Hippocampus Press. This is my favorite. The last volume, volume 5. This is just an excellent book. And of course, S.T. Joshi, with I Am Providence, which is two volumes, he has restored the text that was excised from the Necronomicon Press edition, and he has rewritten, revised, updated the entire text. And this is instantly evident in the first chapter of Volume 2. I'll just read this first paragraph by St. It begins. He quotes a paragraph from Lovecraft's diary of 1925, and then St. writes, "So begins one of the most unusual documents in Lovecraft's entire corpus, his diary for 1925. If it is asked why this document, so seemingly vital for the understanding of his life in this critical year, has only recently been published in the fifth volume, 2006, of the Collected Essays, given that just about every other scrap of Lovecraft's work, exclusive of his letters, has seen print, regardless of its merit or importance, the answer may lie in the somewhat mundane function of the diary. It does not have, and was not designed to have, the literary value of the diaries of Pepys or Evelyn, but was intended merely as a mnemonic aid. It was written in an appointment book for the year 1925, measuring about 2.5 inches by 5¼ inches, with only about 4 lines given for each date. Lovecraft, although not observing the ruled lines very well, he loathed ruled paper, has nevertheless written entries in such a cryptic and abbreviated fashion that some words or terms are still not clear to me." So that's just an example. You know, that is a brand new paragraph written especially for this new 2-volume version of I Am Providence, S.T. Joshi's definitive biography of H.P. Lovecraft. I've been getting inquiries from people here at YouTube and at Amazon, where I have reviewed the book, asking if those who already have the single volume published in 1996 by Necronomicon Press, which is still available from Necronomicon Press in paperback, if you have that, do you really need the 2-volume just published set? I don't think it's imperative, but if you want the full life of H.P. Lovecraft brought up to date, this is the set to have. It is really worth them. It's expensive. It's $100 per set, but they published only 1,000 sets. They will probably sell out before next year is over. And once they are out of print, they will be impossible to find, except for a really exaggerated price. The letters of these sets, Essential Solitude, the letters of H.P. Lovecraft and August Derleth, and the letters of Lovecraft and Robert E. Howard, they were published 1 and 2 years ago. They went out of print quickly, and now those sets are for sale at Amazon for $1,000 a set. So that kind of tells you how the price escalates when these books go out of print. So I highly recommend the 2-volume edition, I Am Providence, of S.T. Joshi's phenomenal and definitive life of H.P. Lovecraft. And Hippocampus Press is where you may order it. So, alright. I need to return to reading more of I Am Providence, reading the life of my muse and my hero, H.P. Lovecraft.